is WCIA 3 News at 10.
We want to end white silence and stand up for racial justice.
Dozens joined together tonight calling on white people to speak up and be better allies to the black community. Good evening, I'm Jessica Coons. A vigil was held outside of Urbana's city building. WCIA 3's Jen Lask was there. She explains what the timing of the vigil meant.
If it weren't for the pandemic, the Urbana City Council would be meeting in person right across the street.
That's why dozens lined the sidewalks outside the building at 7, holding signs calling for an end to white silence. The CU chapter of Bend the Arc Jewish Action and Showing Up for Racial Justice organized the vigil.
I can't imagine how it must feel for somebody to wake up in the morning and know that they or their kids or somebody they love walks out of the house, and just because they're jogging or bird watching or whatever, they might not come home alive. It's time for us to realize this and to stop our silence.
Leaders say it's imperative they make their voices heard.
Rabbi Zimmel in Washington, D.C., who said, wherever Jews find injustice, they're required to fight that injustice. And this is the most unbelievable injustice there can be.
Too often, white people being silent on issues that affect people of color or minorities and brown people, black people in our community, that silence is complicit in upholding systems, oppressive systems of racism.
In addition to standing outside of the city building, organizers asked people to email council members to discuss police reforms. Sanchez Johnson with Black Lives Matter was also at the vigil. He called it a beautiful scene.
Just loving each other for who we are, accepting each other, equal rights for everyone, coming together like we are out here now, you know?
In Urbana, Jen Lask, WCIA 3, your local news leader.
Showing Up for Racial Justice plans to hold more events this week protesting systemic racism.